love the smell of like fresh Chinese.
As opposed to.
I don't know.
People that use forks for rice, bruv. Are you gonna let me know how the prawns are?
Here you go, G. Get stuck in.
Thank you, G. Hi guys, welcome back to our channel.
Oh my gosh, is that what we're doing now? Okay.
Well, when are we gonna do it? Usually when we film, like, we actually get hungry mid-filming and then we order food
anyway.
And then, but we're gonna do our first what, G?
Mukbang.
Mukbang. Basically, my stomach is rumbling. We're basically just going to discuss some unpopular opinions.
Mm-hmm.
Unpopular travel opinions. We didn't even introduce our food, so say hi to our food. We've got some special fried rice, some salt and pepper, ribs.
Chili garlic
king prawns. Abby was like, oh yeah, make sure you order salt and pepper prawns. But they actually didn't have that on the menu, so I just thought I would just freestyle and order what was there.
It's basically not salt and pepper.
How's it supposed to work? Like, is it not rude when you've got food in your mouth and you're talking? Let's have a couple bites first, because my stomach is hella empty. Should we get stuck into those unpopular travel opinions?
Yeah, what was the first one?
Our first one is, are girls really traveling as much as they do because of sugar daddy's coins? I've seen like a lot of chat on Twitter about,
oh, you know, these girls are only going here, they're only going there because someone else is paying.
And on top of that, there are some people who are openly like,
yeah, like having a sugar daddy is the way. How else am I going to get to Dubai and this and Switzerland? Doing spa, doing hotel, doing shopping, doing Monaco.
If that's what you're saying, then live. I wouldn't do it. There are guys out there who are willing to pay. At what expense? Me, I don't know.
Mm-mm.
But if that's you, then live your best life.
I personally think, like, it's not my business how somebody else is funding their lifestyle. Unless it's like, say if it was like my younger sister or my cousin. Yeah. It's really none of my business. I know for me, I am working and I'm saving and
exactly.
Then I'm playing. That's me. I think it's even rude to just be speculating, oh yeah, she must be sponsored. That person must be sponsored. Like, people openly ask them, who's sponsoring you to travel?
That is annoying though.
First of all, don't do that.
Like, naturally, people will assume that because it's Dubai, it has to have been sponsored.
Because apparently it's sugar daddy land.
Yeah.
Why?
Like, you can't go to Dubai on your own coin.
It could even be offensive. Like, someone is working hard.
Like, when you're proper, like, sky scanner searching, someone to just kind of be like, someone paid for you to go. And it's just like, who said I couldn't?
It's almost saying, like, there's no way that you
could have done that on your own.
Could have done that by yourself.
Exactly.
No, I'm sorry. They're literally saying to you, if I can't afford to go to Dubai, you can't afford to go to Dubai. And that's actually, you need to mind your own business. Get your own money up. Get your coins up. Stop spending on fruitless things. And if it's Dubai that you want to go to, put your mind to it and you too can go. I got to eat some sauce here. Oh, that's true. Are solo travellers just friendless and bitter? The narrative I'm seeing, people who are promoting solo travel, is always,
don't wait on your friends, out in this world alone, leave your friends behind, don't let nobody hold you back.
Why are you so angry? Just travel solo and...
True though.
Like, where is the honesty? Where's, like, do you know what?
People's lives have changed. And we can't do group trips like we used to anymore. So it's come to the point where I have to just go by myself.
Where is that? It's not everyday violence and, oh, these friends, are they even there, first of all? These friends, you know what people say, oh, my haters can't tell me nothing.
And it's like, but were there any haters in the first place?
They're not there. So I just feel like, you know, everybody needs to just relax more, because...
Relax, brother.
If you feel like solo travel isn't for you, you shouldn't feel any shame about it. There's no right way to travel. If you love group traveling and you are being held up by your friends, there are people organising group trips. Like, it doesn't mean that you don't go.
World change experiences.
Yeah, shout them out. It doesn't mean that you can't go. It just means, like, you know, find another group to travel with. Abby took me to Milan for my birthday.
Yeah.
Why, if your friends can't go and it's a finance reason and travel is fairly inexpensive. I'm not saying it's cheap.
Yeah.
It's fairly inexpensive. Why can't you take your friend? Because a lot of people were saying, oh, I wish I had a friend like that. I wish I had a friend to take me. Why aren't you the friend mm-hmm. that takes your friend?
Mm-hmm. It's all of, it's the narrative. It's not necessarily the actual action. Don't get me wrong. There are obviously people who are solo traveling and absolutely loving it and like not spreading that narrative. Mm-hmm. So solo travel isn't the issue here. It's more about
the elitism of it.
Yes, be the friend that books your friend a trip. Like, do it because, like, it's possible. Like, we've got a blog post on how, like, on doing it. And I guess, obviously, it comes with a lot of, like, preparation, organisation, yes. Like, I had to just be like, G, you need to take some time off of work. Don't ask me no questions. And you have to be the friend that just says, okay. Mm-hmm. And not start asking no questions. Treat someone else. Not everything is about you. Not mm-hmm. everything is about, oh, solo, me, myself, and I.
Yeah, that's how
sometimes treat someone else. Mm-hmm. Take someone else on holiday. Take someone else to the spa. Take someone else to lunch. Take someone else to afternoon tea. Take someone else to brunch. Just because you can't wait for your friends. Those are your friends' issues. Like, you need to deal with that with your friends. Or maybe get some new friends who are willing to do things with you.
And I know I came with fire earlier, but I just want to add that I actually do admire people that travel alone. More power to you on your solo travel flex.
All the solo travellers are going to come in their numbers. Like,
oh my gosh, it's literally also to no one in particular. It's just like a theme that we've been seeing like yeah. online is
don't every time I see a solo travel friends, tweet, I always send it to Lulu. Oh my
God. Oh, is there a prawn top up?
Yeah.
Thanks, Munching.
Do you want any more rice?
No, you go for it. The mukbang's gonna end and then it's just gonna be cutting. Maybe I should try and eat some of those vegetables.
Yeah. That's what I was thinking, oh yeah, I only took the prawns. I didn't take no veggies. Nothing. I'm a veggie.
You sure?
Yeah, I didn't particularly fancy them.
Oh, sorry.
That's alright.
I do apologise.
It's alright, because the rice is nice.
So we actually finished Chinese. We've moved on yeah. to mukbang.
Mukbang
amaretto lemonades. Should we, as black people,
okay.
stay clear of bait holiday locations?
Okay, so before we do that, what is a bait holiday location? Because to me, the world is the world. So, is it not true? Is the world not the world?
The world is the world. Like, what you're saying is, too many people like me have gone there, therefore it's spoiled. That's a really problematic opinion to have. And I think it's always these people who love to, they love to always go against the grain, loud going against the grain. They don't want to listen to mainstream music.
Oh no, I don't listen to trap. I only listen to conscious rap.
My opinion is, if you want to go somewhere, go.
Yes, I think, yeah, like, who is anybody to tell anybody where you should and shouldn't go?
There are some places that in my head I thought, that's a bit of like a well-known tourist place, like Ibiza is one of them.
Okay,
like,
yeah.
In my head, I wouldn't be like, I must go to Ibiza, because I just felt like, from what I've heard, it's like obviously a clubbing destination, and what am I going to do? Just go there.
I mean, I haven't been to Ibiza.
But I've seen other people to, blog about it, or.
Yes.
And it looks like
it's a completely different place.
So you can never be too sure just because you saw that five people on Twitter went to Santorini. Is it the same Santorini that you're going to experience for yourself?
Yeah.
And if not for all those people going to Santorini, you wouldn't have even envisioned that you yourself could go. So, unpopular opinion, people don't want you to post your holiday pictures online because it makes them jealous. It's always girls getting the flack for this, because girls like to take pictures, number one. Number two, girls like to post pictures long after they've come back from that holiday.
But, yeah.
And that makes people angry. I don't know why.
I would say my experience has been quite different. Like, people, whenever I've posted, people have always been like, oh, where you were look sick, where were you, where did you go, how was it, it looks so good, you're really living your life. Mm-hmm. Like, oh, I had even had someone in church come up to me and be like, oh, where are you off to next, because I know you don't play with your travel. Like, they're just like, they just know now that, like, you know, you can expect to see me somewhere else. Mm-hmm. Outside of the country, on my Instagram, and I like that. So I wouldn't necessarily say I've been met with negativity.
Mm. What about the unpopular opinion that girls don't actually have fun on holiday, they just take pictures to make it look like they do?
I'm on my holiday, you are in your house, and you are telling me on my holiday that me, I'm not having fun. Or what do you think, G? I feel like I've got enough on her.
Looks too pale.
Oh yeah, it did look like a young pea.
There is so much that happens on our trips.
Yeah.
That we don't even get to capture.
All of it.
Gosh. This is why we try to vlog, but what we actually need is someone who is not one of us to just follow us. Like a reality TV
for real.
Because it's always when the camera's down.
That's when someone is doing a madness.
All the time. Unpopular opinion that the number of countries you've gone to doesn't mean sugar honey iced tea. Is it important to be able to say that you've been to X amount of countries?
What, important for what? And for example, like, would you say, okay, Italy, you've got Milan, you've got Venice, you've got Naples, you've got Rome, you've got all of them. Would you count them all as individuals, or would you count that as I've been to Italy? Or
you've
like
been to all those cities, that's one country.
Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. So I just don't get...
Yeah, the number of countries really is irrelevant.
I wouldn't even say, like, I'm a traveller. I would just say that I enjoy traveling. So to me, I'm not trying to validate myself against anybody's rating scale. So the fact that you've been to X amount of countries, to me, it means nothing.
So you agree with that unpopular opinion?
Yes.
The unpopular opinion I was thinking of, when you're with someone and they go on like a girl's holiday, or they go on a lad's holiday, people should be in a position to tell their partners not to go on holiday. If you're saying that I can't go on holiday because I'm with you, then I'm going on holiday and we're no longer together. For me, if I'm with you, I'm going to respect you, and it's not going to be a madness abroad. I'm not going away to do nonsense, because I could fully do that from home if that's what I wanted to do. I'm going to see the world, to enjoy with my friends, to make memories with my friends.
Okay, question though. Hypothetical couple, so we don't know them. Yeah. So girl wants to go on girl's holiday with her girlfriends. Her girlfriends are a bit wayward. They're gonna be like,
bye, I'm off with my man.
Okay, yeah. Then the next one will be like,
see ya, I'm off with my man.
Knowing that, does boy have a right or position to say
that this girl shouldn't go?
Yeah.
Do you trust your girl, do you not trust your girl? Number two, how much of an influence do the friends have on the girl? Like, I know people always say, oh, your friends are a reflection of who you are, but yeah, please allow me to be an individual. Like, if I'm gonna be wayward, I'm gonna be wayward on my own self. I don't necessarily have to bring you in.
You may not be like, oh, I'm actively going out to put you on the bad road. However, you're living your life
and it looks good. It's
and you're enjoying it. Like, does boy have a position to be like, listen, I don't think it's a good idea for you to go on this trip?
Are the couple married?
No. So is that a no?
No, do you know what? Yeah. Madness can happen at home.
But you know what holiday vibes are like, man. You know already. You've already done who's the most likely to fall in love. Like, have a holiday romance. Yeah, yeah. That's true. What if it was a guy that wants to go on holiday?
He absolutely has to stay at home. No, it's the exact same principle. Like, I would, you know, you have to trust him abroad.
Yeah.
The same way you would trust him at home.
Even if it's a stag do, like, there's going to be strippers. Even if it's a stag, there's going to be hella debauchery. There's going to be drinks.
Yeah.
But what I will say is that you who wants to go, do a risk assessment. Like, if you're a guy or a girl and you know that your friends are maybe, like, hella free. Hella free and, like, their man are on liberation.
Are they shackled on the beat as well?
If you know that your friends are going to be mad on holiday, and rightly so they should, just ask yourself if you should be going there. Answer may be yes. The answer may be
yes. This is the last time we're gonna go on this trip.
Or
it's my best friend's dad.
But just do that risk assessment. Assess the risk.
Yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching our videos again. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for leaving comments. Thank you for all the likes. Thank you for following us on our Instagram, our Twitter, our Facebook. Thank you for visiting our blog, flightsandfeelings.co.uk. And yeah, thanks for tuning back in. We finished the food, so we moved on to drinking.
Oh my gosh, that word is still spinning me. Hi guys, welcome back to our channel.
Hi guys!
We've been on a break, but we're back. Bigger. better than ever. It's a bit of drama for you. A girl is tired, boy.
She's also drunk.
Hashtag on the beat as well.